Hi, my name is Dan. In this video, we're going to be using Illustrator to build UI and web graphics. Okay, there's lots of free stuff here on my channel. Please subscribe, hit the little bell next to the subscribe button to get notifications. If you want more, loads more. Okay, check out bringyourownlaptop.com or check out the link in the description. There. In this tutorial, we're going to make these artboards in Illustrator. Okay, this is going to be our desktop size, this is going to be our tablet size, and this is going to be our mobile size. So let's work out what sizes we need to make these first, and then we'll go and build them in Illustrator. So we need to work out what sizes to use, and that can be a little bit tough because it changes over time and there's so many device sizes. But I've got some basics for you to use that what most people use. And if you want to be more informed about kind of what's coming out or what devices are there, there's a really cool site called mydevices.io/devices. So go to that whole URL there in one go. And it just gives you kind of interesting stuff about what sizes. Now ignore these physical heights and widths, use the CSS widths. Okay, this is what we use as our designers. Okay, this is pixels wide. And we can see the new iPhone 7 is 375 pixels wide. So that gives you a good gauge of like, okay, so maybe my mobile needs to be about that, or at least include it because it's one of the more popular phones. You can see the 6 Plus, okay, the big giant phone is even bigger, and I kind of ignore that one. I let him deal with the tablet size because it's such a big phone. It's that big phablet thing. Okay, covers iPhone 6, and you can see all the earlier ones as well. Don't get above 357, okay, 375 even. And so I often just pick my mobile size to be 400 to include all those, but you will be excluding a couple. Okay, the big giant phablet one. I think there's some ones down here like Nexus 6, okay, it was slightly bigger. It's a big phone. It covers most of them. Okay, BlackBerry Passport's massive. Okay, so that's for mobile. You can see down here for tablet, just underneath. You can start looking at these ones. I kind of ignore the iPad Pro. Why? Because it's as big as a desktop. If you've ever gone into like an Apple store and seen the MacBook iPad Pro, they're massive. Okay, so I don't design for those for tablet. I leave those to use the desktop size, but I do cover this one. So that's the size I use for tablet, okay, 768. Now there's no reason why you can't specifically pick other sizes. If you're working with a developer or a web designer after this project, ask them. Okay, say, hey, I'm designing this site. What sizes do you need? Okay, and they might give you ones that are different I'm giving you here, but these would be really typical. So 400 for the mobile, 768 for the tablet, and then you get up to desktop. Okay, and desktop's a bit of a different one. It's what you want to design for, and I'll give you what I do. So let's go and do file new. And we'll start with the desktop as our first design. You can see if we go to web, okay, we've got a lot of different sizes here. Okay, there's web, minimum, large size, common. Okay, you can pick any of these, it doesn't really matter. Okay, what I like to start with is 1200 wide, mainly because it's divisible by our grids that we're gonna learn about a little bit later on. So it's still a common size, okay? But yeah, okay, the height is gonna change a lot when we're working. Okay, so we're gonna leave it at whatever height it defaults to, and we're gonna change it afterwards because it depends on the content. Okay, orientation's going to be landscape, and we're not gonna add any sort of bleed or anything. Okay, so, and we're gonna make sure it's RGB. Okay, let's click create. Great, so there's page one. I'm gonna zoom out a little bit, holding command minus. Okay, zooms out. Now I'm gonna move around holding the spacebar key, clicking and dragging. Okay, so if you hold down the spacebar key on your keyboard, click and drag, or you can use these little sliders around. Okay, so I've got this first one, and they're called artboard instead of pages. Okay, so what I need to do now is create another artboard for my tablet size. So what I'm gonna do is, there's a couple of ways. The easiest way is to up here, there's one called the artboard tool, click on him. Okay, and that kind of allows me to change the size of this if I want to, but what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna click this little option here that says new artboard, okay? And you can see my kind of cursor becomes loaded with a duplicate of this guy. I'm just gonna, you can click it anywhere. I'm just gonna say you live there. Okay, I'm gonna slide across using my spacebar. Now, how big should the tablet be? Okay, I'm going to deal with, we're gonna be doing the width and height, not the X and Y coordinates, okay? So we want the width and height. Now, we kind of talked about it before, how wide is it gonna be? It's gonna be 768, okay? And how tall is it gonna be? It's gonna be depending on the content. So we're gonna design it probably a bit longer, but we're not worried about that at the moment, so don't stress how tall this is. I'm gonna move it across a little bit. Okay, so it's next to my desktop, and now I'm gonna do my mobile version. Now I can go to new again, but that's easy, you've done that. If you hold down the Option key, okay, on your Mac, or the Alt key on your PC, okay, and you can see the cursor changed to that little double arrow, it means it's gonna duplicate it, and I find that's the easiest way to kind of drag out another version. You can keep holding Alt and drag out lots of versions. Okay, I just want three at the moment. So I'm gonna have my desktop, my tablet, and now my mobile. So my mobile version, we talked about it before, okay, we're using width. Okay, so the width in this case is gonna be 400. It encompasses all the new iPhone versions. They're up to 7 now, but who knows what 8's gonna be. So it gives us a little bit of playroom. If it ends up being something stupid like 380, we don't have to go back and redesign our site for mobile. Okay, and the height again, it's gonna change depending on the content. Okay, so it's a lot thinner. So what we'll do before we move away from this, so we've created our pages, we've got a mobile, tablet, and desktop version, is let's go and name them. And we need to find your Artboards tab. If you can't find it, go to Window, and let's go down to Artboards. Okay, and my first one, Artboard one, I'm gonna double click them. Okay, and this one's gonna be called my desktop, and I'm gonna give it a name, okay, so everyone knows that I'm using 1200 pixels. Okay, doesn't change anything, just a label. Artboard 2 is my tablet, okay, and 768 pixels wide, and my mobile, okay, is going to be 400 pixels. Great, all right, I'm gonna zoom out. Remember Command minus or Control minus on a PC, spacebar to move around. Okay, we're getting there. We're gonna save it, file save. Now for this course, I'm gonna put everything on my desktop. Okay, I'm gonna make a new folder, and this is going to be my Dan's portfolio. Okay, and I'm gonna give it a V1. Actually, no, it's the folder name. So we're just gonna call it Dan's portfolio, click create. And now the actual name of this, okay, this is gonna be called Dan's portfolio. Dan's portfolio, give it your name, because we will build your one while we're going along, and give it V1, never call it. It needs some sort of version number. It can be numbers or letters. Never call it final. Final is the kiss of death. You've probably got files called final 2, final revisited, final new. Okay, so just V1 and you'll end up with lots of different versions. Great. Let's click save. Leave everything by default here and let's click OK. And that, my friends, is how to pick the sizes and create your first artboards for our design. How good was that, right? If you want more, go check out bringyourownlaptop.com or check out the link in the description.